True or false? We have wondered if there are aliens elsewhere in the universe for centuries. Actually, it's more like a century. In 1897, a news report of a crash-landed alien spaceship was published. However, it was eventually revealed to be a hoax just to attract more tourists. In the early and mid-20th century, flying saucers were increasingly popular. However, the idea is rather unrealistic. That's better. Now, I want you to think of an intelligent alien race. Just think of the first thing that pops into your head. You most likely thought of this, a short green humanoid with huge dark eyes and a slightly robotic voice. Or, if you're like me, you most likely thought of something like this, a Vulcan. However, an alien race, contrary to Star Trek, doesn't need to look somewhat like a human. They don't even have to have four limbs and a torso. They could have eight limbs on a torso with facial features, assuming they have any, sort of like a tardigrade here on Earth. Another good example is the Eosapien from Alien Planet, whose body is essentially a head with two arms. They are airborne, using a methane-filled sac atop their heads for lift, and organic thrusters to move. Really, all you need are these six things. Number 1. A set of arms, preferably multiple arms, for building shelters, assembling tools, using weapons, and just about anything else that requires hands. Number 2. Something you can use to walk around with, whether it be legs, wings, fins, a long snake-like body, or anything really, just as long as you can move, since it's not really much of a life if you can't move. Number 3. Sensory organs. You need to know what's out there. Use sight, smell, taste, touch, sound, echolocation, electricity, temperature, anything, just as long as it works. Number 4. Social skills. Just because you are sapient doesn't mean you are now immune to predators, disease, and other threats on your own. Invite other members of your own species into your social group. They may know something important that you don't know. They may be strong enough to help you with something. They may also know exactly what to do when you're sick and/or injured. Just let them in. Unless you're a predator, of course, because that's a stupid idea. And you're not stupid. Number 5. A reproductive system. Congratulations, you are now part of an early tribe. But you are not finished just yet. At this rate, your tribe will go good for however long the final individual lives, and just perish. Reproduce. Let your descendants come to rule the planet, whether it's a bad thing or not. It's just evolution. And number 6. Finally, the most important thing on the list. The ultimate requirement. The pinnacle of being sapient. The thing that allows you to be considered sapient. Are you ready for it? Here it is. A good brain. The better your brain is, the more intelligent and logical you are. You can't go to your planet's moon or anything without being smart, right? Unless, of course, your planet doesn't actually have a moon. So that might give you an idea of what they could be like, but how likely are they to exist? The likelihood of alien life is almost 100% true simply because of how vast the universe is. 93 billion light years across, and that's just what we've seen. In Star Trek, the planet Vulcan is located about 16 light years away from Earth, orbiting the star 40 Eridani. Vulcan is a Class M planet, meaning it is relatively Earth-like in how it can support life. Class L planets are kind of like what Earth was like 1 or 2 billion years ago. So what are some good examples of some real-life Class M exoplanets? NASA's Kepler satellite has already located dozens of potentially life-supporting planets. When you clicked on this video, you may have seen a potentially life-supporting planet in the thumbnail. That planet is Kepler-22b, or at least an artist's concept of it. However, the mass of it is nearly 10 times that of Earth's mass, and it lies 587 light-years away, meaning that it's too far and possibly has too much gravity to be an Earth, too. Other examples include KOI 1686.01, KOI 494.01, Gliese 581G, Tau Ceti E, and 23 others so far. Unfortunately, the planets that are likely habitable right now are hundreds of light years away, and the closer ones will need to be terraformed. However, the likelihood of them visiting us is not very high. For that, the race needs to travel throughout interstellar, and sometimes intergalactic space. For that, they're going to need something kind of like a warp drive. However, traveling at warp speed isn't really as easy as it sounds. However, we might just have to be the ones who visit them. Thank you for watching this video. If you like it, then please give this video a like, share it with your friends, and subscribe. Do you have something you want us to explain? Please leave a response in the comments below. Live long and prosper.